A believer fears not but Allah. A believer fears not but Allah. That's what we should be. We should fear nobody but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing should be scaring us. No man can bring us down. No government can do us. Right? We are believers in Allah ta'ala. We should have so much iman in Allah that we only. وَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِي إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Don't fear them. If you believe, then you only fear me. You only fear Allah. And you know, we say, brother, I only fear Allah. You know, you see so many man, bro, I ain't scared of you, I only fear Allah. I only fear Allah. You know, if you really feared Allah, what about His punishment? Are you scared of that? If you truly feared Allah, you wouldn't miss a salah. If you truly feared Allah, you would follow the sunnah of Rasulullah. Don't give me this excuse, I only fear Allah. What fear of Allah do you have if you miss prayer? But don't you know Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ. Don't you know that the punishment of Allah is severe? Don't you know Allah Almighty is so severe in His punishment? When you see His mercy, you should look at His justice as well. You know this excuse our man gives us. I only fear Allah. You can't judge me, I only fear. If you truly feared Allah, then you should be worried what Allah will judge you. How will Allah judge you? And if you can sit there and justify to me, that you only fear Allah and I can miss Salah, you have no fear of Allah Almighty, you are a fool, you are fooling yourself. And Shaitan has wrapped you around his little finger. That's what he has done. Shaitan's got you under wraps, that's what's happened. He's got you because you don't fear Allah. Shaitan has put it in this section for you to tell people, I fear Allah. You don't fear no Allah. You don't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A believer fears Allah at all times. A believer doesn't have a moment where he doesn't fear Allah. He does everything he does, he thinks about the consequence. True fear of Allah stops a man from sinning. True fear from Allah Almighty draws a man closer to his Lord. Fear of Allah, yeah. Friday nights and nightclubs, fear of Allah, where's that fear gone? What happened to that statement, I fear Allah? Think 100 times before you tell someone, I fear Allah. Because man can put you in your place. And if you truly fear Him, and you're truly a believer, then I swear by Allah, in a believer's heart, Nabi alayhi salam said, no two fears can enter one believer's heart. No two fears. A believer only fears Allah, or he only fears the dunya. He can't fear two things at one time. And sadly, no matter how much we say, we're scared of this dunya. We're scared of people, what people will say. We want to change something in our lifestyle, we're scared. You grow a beard, maybe you lose a few girls that you talk to. That's why we're scared to do it. You go to a wedding, you don't want to do your wedding in the sunnah way because you're scared, because people will say things to you. As right, if you truly fear Allah, you don't care what people will say. You put people on one side and say, I'm worried what Allah thinks of me. That's what a believer's mentality is. That's how a believer thinks. Nobody people, what do they say? And I'm scared. God knows what will happen. You should only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, before you do something, and something courageous and bold, you say, I only fear Allah, if I die, I die. A believer, you see, when you're truly fearful of Allah Almighty, then death doesn't even scare you. Death doesn't scare a believer. What do you think? Death scares a believer? How many times do we think about death? You know why we don't think about death? Because we're scared of death. We're scared to die as people. And somebody can stand up and say, Imam Sahib, I ain't scared to die. No. The reality of it is we are scared to die. We are scared to show our face to Allah. But you know, a believer, he said, put death in front of me. Khalid bin Walid, when he entered into the army and he entered on the battlefield, he said to the Roman and the Persians, he said, you know, look into the eyes of these mu'mins. Look into the eyes of these believers. They desire and love death more than you love life. These people are prepared to die for their religion. We call ourselves believers. Are we prepared to die for our deen? Are we prepared to sacrifice our lives for our deen? And what does that mean? That means forget the external battlefield, rather the battlefield inside you. Forget the call of duty out there, it's about the call of duty inside you. What's happening with this call of duty? Have you answered this call? There's a war going on inside your heart. Shaitan is with his army attacking you. How are we doing? How do we respond to him? How do we have? And more, what do? We say, forget it, man. Tomorrow I'll read. And before you know it, Shaitan's got you so lost. Your mind has been so wounded. You've gone so far from the deen that you don't know where to start to come back. And this is the sad state of our people today. Our people are becoming like this. Why? Because we started fearing everything other than Allah. You know, the companions only feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is nothing that feared them except Allah Almighty. That fear is what you call taqwa. That fear is what you call consciousness. Being conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we truly fear Allah, we'll stop doing these things to our eyebrows. We'll stop shaving the beard. We will grow the beard and follow the sunnah of Rasulullah. Because why? We're scared the face that we will show to Allah. What face? Who did you used to imitate? Who were you copying when you were shaving? Tell me. Which sunnah were you denying? What answer will we give to Allah Almighty when that question will be asked? Truly, if we feared, we would straight away think, nah, you know what? If I grow the beard, certainly I will read my salah with it. You will let nothing stop you from reading namaz. Let the beard encourage you. You know why people don't grow beards? They say, hey, Imam Sahib, if I grow a beard, then I have to read namaz. I'm not ready to read namaz. Therefore, I don't want to grow a beard. And 40 years will go like this. Excuses. When will these excuses end? Who are we trying to make excuses for? Tomorrow, what excuse will you give to Allah? Never mind me and you. What excuse will me and you give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What will we say to Allah? You neglected my Prophet Sunnah. I see him as the best role model and example. And I'm not just saying this Sunnah, this is one Sunnah. Hazrat lying, going against the Sunnah of Rasulullah to lie. Whether it's our character, whether it's our appearance, don't just think that Imam Sahib is all about. No, it's not all about the beard. Some of the greatest men that came didn't have beards. They were forced not to have beard because of political situations. Like in Egypt, like great men like Dr. Allama Iqbal, these people, they didn't have beard, but they were great men of Allah. I'm not saying it's all about the beard, but you know this beard when it grows, when you see it, no doubt, amazing. Then the turban starts to come on. Then slowly his salah starts to get better. And then you know when there's some people you find that have beards, but they are so lost in the dunya. They are the biggest dealers, biggest fraudsters, biggest gangsters, and they've got beards. And you think, subhanAllah, this beard doesn't stop you. This beard doesn't stop you. Okay, forget it. Forget the beard. What about the fear of Allah? Doesn't the fear of Allah stop you? وَلَا تَخَافُهُمْ وَخَافُونِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ. Don't fear them, fear me. If you truly believe, you will only fear me.